Khanna, who's a senior fellow at the New America Foundation and author of a great new book, How to Run the World, and Saskia Sassen, Robert Lynn Professor of Sociology at the in the Department of Sociology and the Committee on Global Thought, which I find slightly Orwellian, but we'll hear more about at Columbia University. Welcome to both of you. We're delighted to have you.
Thank you.
Parag, let's start with you. When we talk about globalization, it seems barriers are falling. This is an age where, of interconnectedness. Is there still a relevance for the city? You have an argument that this is the age of the city.
That's absolutely right. By the way, you know, Vijay, you're never lacking for boldness, but I almost wish that you would title this the new world order instead of just new world order.
We've already moved on, haven't we? That's,
well, see, that term was coined exactly 20 years
it's
ago
so
by
nice.
George H.W. Bush in his speech to the United Nations, and that was, we presumed, it was going to continue to be an age of nations, but I think that the world that we have entered is not just a structural change, where the West is no longer dominant, but you also have the East and rising powers and so forth. What we are experiencing is a systems change, where you move beyond just the state and you have this plurality of actors. I'm not saying necessarily that the city dominates over the state, but that you have to take both into account very much. And that world, that new world order, as it were, looks a lot like, in fact, the world of 1,000 years ago, the Middle Ages. In the medieval world, yes, you had China as one of the most advanced civilizations. It had the largest cities.
Right.
You also had India as a powerful player. The Arab Islamic world was powerful as well. The West was weak and divided. But the borders of empires at that time were nothing like the rigid, predictable nation-state borders that we have today. It was fluid, curvy lines on the map and on the globe. And cities exploited that openness. Venice and Bruges, when they set up the first stock exchanges and extended credit commercially, they enabled globalization 1.0, the Silk Road, and the formation of the first intercontinental trading system took place 1,000 years ago. Cities were the drivers of that, and cities are again driving that today.
Well, and we had the Hanseatic League, of course, which was at its hub connected by cities. Saskia Sassen, you've spent a lifetime thinking about this topic. It seems to be quite fashionable, a very short and attractive lifetime, of course, but nevertheless,
a
lifetime.
100 years.
Exactly. The cities are very